犹大书。
Let's continue our previous study, Jude.
我们看犹大书。
Let's turn to Jude.
犹大书的二十节、二十一节。
Jude verse 20 and 21. But you, beloved, building yourselves up on your most holy faith, praying in the Holy Spirit, keep yourselves in the love of God, looking for the mercy of our Lord Jesus Christ unto eternal life.
我们人生的集中追求就是得到永生。
The ultimate pursuit of our life is to obtain eternal life.
主耶稣来世界上给我们最大的盼望就是能够回到父那里去。
The greatest hope that Lord Jesus came to bring to us is that we can return to our Heavenly Father.
所以我们一生就是为着这个目标在努力。
And all of us are striving toward this very goal.
那在二十节、二十一节，我们可以看到要得到永生，有两部分。
In verse 20 and 21, we see that there are two steps to obtaining eternal life.
第一个是人的本分。
First is the human effort.
就是我们本身需要的努力。
Which is the endeavors we need to exercise.
因为圣经说，天国是努力的人进去的。
For the Bible tells us that only those who strive hard can enter into heaven.
那二十节、二十一节有三点，就是我们需要努力的。
In verse 20 and 21, outlines three points in which we must endeavor.
那除了人的努力之外，还要加上神的怜悯。
Other than human efforts, we also need to add upon the mercy of God.
如果只有神的怜悯，人没有努力，也进不去。
If by God's mercy alone, without human efforts, then we cannot enter into heaven.
那如果只有人的努力，没有神的怜悯，也没有办法达到。
If by human efforts alone, without the mercy of God, then we also cannot enter into heaven.
我们来看二十四节。
Let's read verse 24.
请读。
Now to him who is able to keep you from stumbling and to present you faultless before the presence of his glory with exceeding joy.
这里在描写我们所拜的救主耶稣，独一的神。
Here it describes our Lord Jesus Savior, who is the only true God.
他能保守我们不失脚。
He is able to keep us from stumbling.
好像保守彼得，虽然一时软弱，但是不失脚，没有跌倒。
Just as he kept Peter from stumbling, even though he had stumbled, but he returned.
那彼得会软弱是在二十节这个前面三点人的努力上他做得不够。
The reason why Peter failed was because he did not put enough effort into the human component.
但是犹大却失脚。
But we see Jude actually slipped and fell.
虽然神要保守他，最后他就倒下去了。
And even though Jesus Christ had intended to keep him until the very end, but he fell and he could not get up.
就是在前面的三点人的努力上，他没有去做。
And the reason why he failed was because he didn't have sufficient human effort in the previous three.
那我们信主，信了几十年，到现在还能信。
All of us have been believing in Jesus Christ for many years, and we are still in the faith.
当然我们本身有在努力。
Of course, we do have our human efforts.
但是更重要是因为神怜悯我们，他保守我们。
But more importantly, it's because out of God's mercy to protect us.
那下面说叫你们无瑕无耻，欢欢喜喜地站在他荣耀之前。
And it goes on to say that to present us faultless before the presence of his glory with exceeding joy.
我们将来能够站在神面前得奖赏，也是神的怜悯。
To be able to stand in the presence of God to receive our rewards also out of God's mercy.
是因为他的帮助，我们才能够渐渐完全。
It is out of God's help that we are able to become perfected slowly.
如果不是神的帮助
，without the help of God，
我们的努力也成就不了什么。
Then by mere human effort, it's not going to accomplish much.
因为我们人里面有无知，又有罪性。
Because within humanity, there is ignorance and sin.
这不是个人努力能够完全克服的。
And these are things in which by mere human effort we cannot overcome.
所以进到天国需要人的努力加上神的怜悯。
Thus, in order to enter into heavenly kingdom, we need to have the human effort plus the grace of God.
那到底我们要努力什么？
What exactly need we to strive to work?
如果我们回来看二十节。
Let's come back to verse 20.
你们要在至圣的真道上造就自己。
Building ourselves up on our most holy faith.
这个造就这个是中文翻比较难了解，如果用英文再翻回来，就是在至圣的真道上来建立自己。
We are to build ourselves up on our most holy faith.
那如果我们看那个英文 faith 有两个翻译，一个是信仰，一个把它翻作真道。
Faith has two interpretation. One is belief, and the other is truth.
好像以弗所书第四章讲七个一。
Just like Ephesians chapter 4 mentions seven ones.
那里面讲一信，就是只有一种信仰。
One faith, which means there is only one belief.
那这个信仰其实也是指着只有一种真道真理。
This one belief also means that signifies that there is only one truth.
所以要在至圣的信仰上或者真道上来建立自己。
And hence to build ourselves up on our most holy faith.
为什么？
For what reason?
我们大家需要来思考的。
This is something we need to contemplate.
如果没有在真道上努力，又会怎样？
And what's going to happen if we don't put any effort into striving after truth?
那如果努力在真道上建立自己，又有什么不同？
And if we put effort into building ourselves up in truth, then what's the difference?
我们来看哥罗西书第二章。
Colossians chapter 2.
哥罗西书的第二章。
Colossians 2.
第七节
Verse 7. Rooted and built up in him and established in the faith, as you have been taught, abounding in it with thanksgiving.
这里说要在他里面生根建造。
Here says that we are to be rooted and built up in him.
然后信心坚固。
Establish in the faith.
那怎么在主耶稣里面好像一棵树这样生根建造。
And how are we to be rooted and built up in Jesus Christ like a tree?
我们现在看第二节。
Let's read verse 2.
第二节到第四节。
To verse 4. That their hearts may be encouraged, being knit together in love, and attaining to all riches of the full assurance of understanding, to the knowledge of the mystery of God, both of the Father and of Christ. 3. In whom are hidden all the treasures of wisdom and knowledge,For now, this I say, lest anyone should deceive you with persuasive words.
当然，我们信仰生活是讲爱心呢。
Naturally, in our faith, we need to concentrate on love.
所以这里有说，因为爱心互相联络。
And it says here, because of love, we are knit together.
是教会的弟兄姊妹，好像是一个家庭的亲弟兄姐妹。
So that all members in Christ are together as one single family.
那下面说，充充足足在悟性中有充足的信心。
And attaining to all riches of the full assurance of understanding.
这个迷信跟我们的信仰有什么不同？
What is the difference between superstition and faith?
迷信是没有办法解释的信仰。
Superstition is a faith in which it cannot be explained.
你怎么去拜祖宗？
Why do you want to worship your ancestor?
把他当神来拜，这个没有办法解释。
When you consider the deceased people as God and worship them, it's inexplicable.
为什么人自己造一个神，然后来拜自己造的神？
Why would human hands create craft some sort of idols and then bow down to their own handicraft?
这个没有办法解释。
This is also inexplicable.
这个叫做迷信。
This is called superstition.
但是我们的信仰。
However, when we have faith,
这里说在悟性中有充足的信心。
Here says that attaining all riches of the full assurance of understanding.
我们的信仰是经的是用这个悟性属灵的领悟力去了解一套道理，它是建筑在这个道理上。
Our faith is something that we can grasp through our understanding, so that it makes sense to us.
所以整本圣经就是在讲我们信仰的前因后果。
The entire Bible is speaking about the cause and effect of belief.
从神的创造开始。
Beginning from the creation of God.
讲到人跟神的关系。
And then onto the relationship between God and man.
讲到从人的外在的生活，讲到人的内心。
And to go from the external lives into our internal heart.
哦，从人的今生讲到来世。
To go from the present life into the future life.
从神的公义讲到神的慈爱。
From God's justice into God's mercy.
哦，所以这个里面有很深奥的道理。
And we can see that there is very deep understanding within this.
那如果神给我们圣灵，我们就有属灵的领悟力。
And if God gives us the Holy Spirit, then we have this spiritual understanding.
对圣经的了解越来越深。
And we can get a fuller grasp of the biblical truth.
那这个叫做在主耶稣里面生根建造。
This is what it means to be rooted in Jesus Christ and be built up.
那这个也叫做我们的信心是有根基的。
And this is when we take root in our faith.
因为我们了解我们在信什么。
Because we understand what exactly we believe in.
那这个悟性的了解到最后就是对神的了解。
This rational understanding eventually leads to the full understanding of God.
因为所有的知识都是从神来的。
Because all knowledge points to God.
所以到最后我们是对神认识的知识越来越多，越来越深。
And therefore, eventually our understanding of God becomes deeper and more abundant.
所以第三节啊
，Verse 3,
一切的智慧知识都在它里面藏着。
In whom are all hidden in all the treasures of wisdom and knowledge.
那到最后我们想的啊，跟我们从神认识的知识一样。
And then eventually our understanding will be exactly on the same wavelength as God.
我们对每一个人生很重要的这个主题啊，我们的看法跟神的知识一样。
All the themes and major perspective on life would become parallel to God's understanding.
那这个叫做有智慧。
Then this is what it means to have wisdom.
我看的跟神一样，就是有智慧。
When we share the same perspective as God, that means we have wisdom.
所以为什么要在至圣的真道上造就自己？
And this is why we need to be rooted and be built up in our holy faith.
是我们的信心有根有基。
And such that we have root, we are rooted in faith.
那如果是这样，
And if this is the case,
那看第二章的第四节。
Let's read chapter 2, verse 4.
以弗所书二章四节。
Ephesians 2, verse 4. Now this I say, lest anyone should deceive you with persuasive words.
这里说，免得有人用花言巧语迷惑你们。
So that people don't deceive us with persuasive words.
所以当我们的信仰是建立在我们属灵的领悟上，就不会被迷惑。
When our understanding is built upon the grasp of our spiritual truth, then we will no longer be deceived.
因为我知道我在信什么。
Because we know what we believe in.
我知道我所信的是从神来的。
Because we understand what we believe in comes from God.
对，如果你讲的跟我信的不一样，那不是我有问题，是你讲错。
And therefore, if whatever you say is different from my belief, then you are at fault. I am not at fault.
所以这样就有一个分辨力。
And now we have this discernment.
那如果这个信仰没有一种属灵领悟力，分辨不清。
But if our belief lacks this spiritual wisdom, then it's hard for us to differentiate.
就容易被迷惑。
And it's very easy for us to be persuaded.
所以第二章第八节哈。
Chapter 2, verse 8.
有人用他的理学跟虚空的妄言，不是照着基督，乃照人间的遗传，跟世上小学般的掳去了。
Beware lest anyone cheat you through philosophy and empty deceit, according to the tradition of men, according to the basic principles of the world, and not according to Christ.
这个人间的遗传也可以讲人的文化，人的传统。
These are human traditions.And philosophies.
你如果活到三四十岁哦，一个人这个文化啊，差不多已经变成他思想一个很重要的一部分。
By the time a person gets to age 30 or 40, the culture of this person becomes a very important component of his thinking.
那世上的小学啊，就是指着人所发明的理论。
And the human philosophies refer to the thinking that people invent.
那这一些在至圣的真道上比较下，这个都是叫做小学。
When you compare all of these to the truth of God, these are merely considered as the basic principles of the world.
这个没有办法帮助人认识神。
They cannot lead us to understanding God.
也没有办法真的让人得智慧。
Nor can it really bring wisdom to us.
但是这个占大部分人的思想。
However, this pretty much occupies all the human thinkings.
所以我们才不会被抓走。
And therefore, we need to be secure in our understanding of the truth, so we will not be dissuaded.
因为当我们了解我们在信什么。
Because when we understand what our belief is,
我们就知道大部分人跟我们想法不一样。
We will understand that most people think differently from us.
所以我们会觉得很孤单。
And we will feel lonely.
但是如果知道我们想的是对的。
But if we understand that what we believe in is correct,
这个孤单是有价值的。
Then this lonesomeness is worthwhile.
我们不会被同化。
We will not be transformed.
但是如果我们不知道我们在信什么。
But if we don't understand what we believe in,
我们被觉得自己很孤单
and we feel lonely,
我们就想要去认同我们周围人的想法
and we would like to be assimilated and be conformed to others around us,
觉得被接纳变成大家的一部分
and we feel like we will be accepted and become one of them,
那这个常常对真理就是一种妥协
but this oftentimes is a compromise to God's truth,
所以为什么要在真道上来建立自己
and why do we need to build ourselves up in the truth?
我们看以弗所书第四章
Ephesians 4
以弗所书第四章
Ephesians 4
11节
Verse 11
12节
And 12 And him himself gave some to be apostles, some prophets, some evangelists, and some pastors and teachers, 12 For the equipping of the saints for the work of ministry, for the edifying of the body of Christ
这个地方讲教会里面有各种不同恩赐的工人
Here it says thatThere are various types of gifted, talented workers in Christ.
有的有恩赐传福音，有的有恩赐牧养。
Some are given to be apostles, prophets, evangelists.
有的有恩赐做教员。
Some are teachers and pastors.
那这一些恩赐到底要做什么
？And what exactly is the point of having all those talents?
十二节。
Verse 12.
要成全圣徒，各尽其职，建立基督的身体。
For the equipping of the saints for the work of ministry, for the edifying of the body of Christ.
到最后就是要让基督的身体得到建立。
Eventually, the goal is to build up the body of Christ.
那基督的身体就是教会。
The body of Christ is church.
那教会要被建立，最重要是所有的信徒要各尽其职。
For our church to be built up, it means all of the members in Christ must be fully be used to their maximum.
因为每一个人都是身体的一部分。
Because each one of us is a part of this body.
身体每一部分都有用的。
Every part of the body is functional.
当每一部分都有用，这个身体就是很健康。
When every part of this body is functional, then we have a healthy body.
它就会成长。
And it will grow.
那一部分没有功用，这个身体就生病了。
When a particular part is useless and lost its function, then this body is sick.
有时候就没有办法成长。
And we cannot grow.
所以每个信徒要在教会发挥功用。
And thus, every member in Christ must be fully tapped to their maximum potential.
第二十二节的第一句话，成全，英文叫 equipped. Equipped 再翻回来就是要接受装备。
And verse 12 says that we need to be equipped.We need to be receive certain type of equipment.
所以我们在教会里面要侍奉，这是应该的。
So it's very natural for us to serve in the church.
但是要侍奉要先装备。
However, in order to serve, we must first be equipped.
那要怎么装备
？How do we equip ourselves?
当然就是要在神的话上。
Of course, we need to equip ourselves in the Word of God.
用至圣的真道来建立我们自己。
Using the most holy truth in order to build ourselves up.
你如果一个军队没有经过训练
when a troop goes without training,
你开到战场没有办法打战
and you bring them to the battlefield, they are not able to fight.
因为他不晓得怎么打，也不晓得敌人从哪里来
because they don't know how to fight the most basics, and they don't know where the enemies are coming.
我们有好的装备，在真理上好的装备，我们的侍奉就会渐渐完全。
When we are well equipped in the truth of God, then spiritually we are well guarded.
为什么？因为通过这个真理的造就，我们每一个人就直接连到头脑，就是基督本身了。
And through the understanding of the truth, each one of us is directly connected to the brain, which is Jesus Christ Himself.
所以我们的侍奉就是以头下命令，我们可以感受得到这样来做。
And in our servitude, we accept the commands. We are able to sense the commands and follow accordingly from the head.
那这个没有真理侍奉过，我们开始一侍奉，我们就知道我们会出很多问题。
But if a person is not connected to the head, and start serving, then we know there's going to be problems.
第一个是动机。
First of all, is the motive.
第二个是态度。
Second is the attitude.
第三个是方法。
Third is method.
哦，这个每一个都有真理的教导。
So each stage requires the teaching of the truth.
好，那这个造就到最后的目标是什么
？What is the ultimate goal of this edifying process?
十三节。
Verse 13.
在真道上同归于认识神的儿子，得以长大成人，满有基督成长的身量。
Till we all come to the unity of faith and of the knowledge of the Son of God, to a perfect man, to the measure of the stature of the fullness of Christ.
不知道什么是完全，我们就不知道我们不完全。
If we don't know what is perfect, then we will not sense how imperfect we are.
看到主耶稣，我们就知道自己不完全。
But when we see face to face with Christ, then we know how imperfect we are.
如果不知道主耶稣的刚强，我们就不知道自己的软弱。
If we don't know the strength of Christ, then we don't know our human weakness.
如果我们不知道主耶稣的智慧，我们就不知道我们自己是没有智慧的。
If we don't understand the wisdom of Christ, then we will fail to understand that we are without wisdom.
如果我们不知道主耶稣的爱心，我们就不知道我们没有爱心。
If we don't know about the love of Christ, then we will fail to understand we lack love.
所以当我们对主耶稣认识越来越深。
And thus, when we have deeper and deeper understanding of Jesus Christ,
就是透过真理,
it is only done so through truth.
那我们就越发现我们是不完全的。
Then we will discover that we are so imperfect.
然后一直去努力，我们就越来越完全。
As we strive toward perfection, we will become better and better.
那我们的服事就越来越像主耶稣。
And our servitude will become closer and closer to the likeness of Christ.
就会越来越有果效。
And we will be able to bear fruit.
所以每个侍奉神的，包括连在厨房里面煮饭的，包括做吸地板的，都要经过属灵的装备。
And thus, every person that serves God, whether you are mopping the floor or working in the kitchen, each person must be spiritually equipped.
所以我们的侍奉才能够真的让神得到喜悦。
Only by doing so will our service be, will delight God.
因为我们是照着他的样式来侍奉他。
Because we are serving God according to His likeness.
那如果神会喜欢的侍奉，一定对人有帮助。
Any kind of service that would delight God is also beneficial to humankind.
神会喜欢的侍奉，一定对自己有好处。
If God delights in our service, it means it's also beneficial to ourselves.
所以侍奉到最后好不好，只有一句话：神喜欢不喜欢。
So whether or not our service is good, ultimately depends on whether God delights in us.
这个要有敏感度。
This requires sensitivity.
那这个敏感度就是真道上的造就，加上圣灵的感动。
This kind of sensitivity is built up through the edifying process of the truth and also movement of the Holy Spirit.
所以侍奉不能没有装备的。
And thus, we cannot serve without equipping ourselves.
也就是说，没有在真道上长进。
Which means, if we don't grow in the truth.
所以为什么在真道上要成长？
This is why do we need to grow in the truth?
那十四节
Verse 14.
说不在众人的诡计和欺骗的法术被一窍异教之风所摇动飘来飘去随从各样的异端
That we should no longer be children tossed to and fro and carried about with every word, every wind of doctrine by the trickery of man in the cunning craftiness of deceitful plotting.
当我们这个属灵的悟性对神的真理领悟越来越多
When our spiritual understanding becomes deeper and deeper in Christ,
就不会被异教之风摇动。
We will not be tossed to and fro by the wind of doctrine.
飘来飘去啊，信仰站不稳。
Tossed about as though we are stumbling about.
由于那个新的学说、新的理论出来，就开始就对自己所信的起怀疑。
Whenever there is a new school of thought, we start to doubt our faith.
怎么这么容易怀疑呢？
Why do we suspect so easily?
难道我们对自己所信的不了解吗?
Do we not understand our own belief?
如果了解，为什么会去怀疑呢?
If we understand our belief, why do we doubt?
所以要在真理上造就。
And thus we must be edified in the truth.
我们回来看第二点。
Let's come back to the previous. Jude.
犹大书二十一节。
Jude verse 21.
二十节，在圣灵里祷告。
Verse 20, and to praying in the Holy Spirit.
这里特别讲要在圣灵里祷告。
It specifically mentions praying in the Holy Spirit.
我们现在回来看为什么我们得圣灵的 用悟性祷告不够了，一定要用灵言祷告。
Now let's look at why a mere prayer in understanding is not adequate. We must pray in the Holy Spirit.
好，我们看罗马书。
Let's turn to Romans.
罗马书的第八章。
Romans 8.
二十八节
，verse 28. Romans 8, verse 28. And we know that all things work together for good to those who love God, to those who are called according to His purpose.
这里讲啊，万事互相效力。
All things work together.
照爱神的人得益处。
For good to those who love God.
啊，如果万事是指着顺利的，我们都大家都可以了解。
If all things work together means everything is smooth sailing, then we can understand this.
但是比较难了解是我们不愿意的，我们不喜欢的发生了。
Now, what's harder to understand is when something difficult or crisis comes our way.
有时候对我们的信仰生活就一个起的很大的挑战。
And this will become a great challenge to our faith.
有时候对我们的侍奉就起的很大的挑战。
And also be a great challenge to our service to God.
为什么我们这么热心侍奉会遇到这样的事情呢？
Why do we work for God so zealously and still encounter this kind of troubles?
但是下面说叫爱神的人得益处。
But it goes on to say for the good to those who love God.
如果我们坚持我一切都是为着爱神。
If we persist and insist that whatever we do is to out of our love for God.
我们对万事的回应都是出于爱，对神的爱。
And our response to all circumstances is because of our love for God.
到最后我们一定会得益处。
And eventually, a benefit will befall us.
但是这个过程有时候是很难很难的。
But often, this process is an arduous one.
所以才有二十六节。
This is why verse 26.
我们的软弱有圣灵帮助我们。
Likewise, the Holy Spirit also helps us in our weakness.
当一个人在极度软弱的时候。
When a person is in extreme weakness,
在个人的生活中
in that person's life,
或者在侍奉当中
or in his service to God,
极度软弱
extremely weak,
神的旨意也想不通
and he cannot figure out what is God's purpose.
有的软弱到最后讲啊，就不信了
Some people become so weak that they decided to give up their faith.
或者说啊，不再侍奉了。
Or no longer to serve God.
这个就是软弱的表现。
And this is one of the possibilities of weaknesses.
那时候我们不晓得怎么祷告。
And at that time, we don't know how to pray anymore.
但是圣灵用说不出来的叹息替我们祷告。
But the Holy Spirit Himself intercedes for us with groanings which cannot be uttered.
圣灵知道我们的需要。
The Holy Spirit fully understands our needs.
圣灵知道神的旨意。
The Holy Spirit understands the will of God.
所以圣灵代替我们按着神的旨意，为着我们的需要来祷告。
And thus the Holy Spirit intercedes on our behalf according to the will of God.
那这一种祷告最完全。
This type of prayer is the most perfect one.
有时候我们觉得我们自己很认识自己。
At times we feel as though we know ourselves fully well.
但是如果不认识神，我们就不认识自己。
However, if we fail to understand God, then we fail to understand ourselves.
因为神是一面镜子。
Because God is like a mirror.
彼得说：“我要为你而死。”
Peter said to Christ that I am going to die for you.
主耶稣说：“你要三次不认我。”
Lord Jesus told him that you are going to deny me three times.
到底谁比较认识彼得？
And who exactly knows Peter better?
原来彼得对自己都不认识。
And Peter did not even understand himself.
但主耶稣却能够看透万事。
But Lord Jesus is able to see through all things.
所以主耶稣已经为他祷告了。
And Lord Jesus already interceded for him.
叫他能够站立起来。
Such that he can, after stumbling, he can get up again.
圣灵就是耶稣的灵。
The Holy Spirit is the Spirit of Christ.
他已经看透我们的需要。
He has seen through all of our needs.
他知道我们的需要。
For he understands full well of our needs.
他也知道神的意思。
He also understands the full will of God.
所以在我们不知道我们需要的时候，圣灵已经代替为我们祷告。
And even before we realize what we need, the Holy Spirit already interceded for us.
所以要在至圣的真道上造就自己，接下去要在圣灵里祷告。
So after we build ourselves in the truth, the next thing we have to do is pray in the Holy Spirit.
我们看以弗所书第四章。
Ephesians 4.
以弗所书的第四章。
Ephesians 4.
第四章第一节一直到第三节。
Ephesians 4, verse 1 to 3. I, therefore, the prisoner of the Lord, beseech you to walk worthy of the calling with which you were called to, with all lowliness and gentleness, with long-suffering, bearing with one another in love. 3, endeavoring to keep the unity of the Spirit in the bond of peace.
这个第一节特别讲，行事为人要与蒙召的恩相称。
Verse 1 says that we should walk according, worthy of the calling which you were called.
到第三节。
Verse
3. 就特别讲竭力保守圣灵所赐合而为一的心。
It stresses that endeavoring to keep the unity of the Spirit in the bond of peace.
所以为什么要在圣灵里祷告？
So why should we need to, why do we need to pray in the Holy Spirit?
因为神的灵在每个人的心里面感动我们。
Because the Holy Spirit is able to go through everyone's heart to move us.
那这个神的灵感动到最后就是要让我们的心都归回向神。
The movement of the Holy Spirit ultimately is to bring everyone toward God.
所以箴言里面说，我的儿子啊，你要将心归我。
The proverb says that my son, return your heart to me.
天上的神在呼叫他的儿子要把心归向他。
Heavenly God is calling on humankind to return our hearts back to Him.
那每个人都被圣灵充满。
When each one of us is filled by the Holy Spirit,
都被圣灵感动。
We are all moved by the Holy Spirit.
那就每个人心都归向神。
And all of our hearts will return to God.
那大家的心都归向神，这个心就合一了。
When we all of our hearts are turned to God, then we are united as one.
所以为什么在圣灵里祷告？
So why do we need to pray in the Holy Spirit?
因为圣灵里的祷告能够让我们合一。
Because the prayer in the Holy Spirit will bring us into unity.
好。那我们现在看，回头看犹大书。
Turn back to Jude.
犹大书的十九节十八节十九节。
Jude verse 18 and 19. How they told you that there would be mockers in the last time who would walk according to their own ungodly lusts. 19. These are sensual persons who cause divisions, not having the Spirit.
这个十八跟十九节哈，在提到当时有所谓的假使徒。
Verse 18 and 19 tells us that in those days there were already false apostles.
就是在当时传的道理跟一次交付圣徒的真道不一样。
Which means they were preaching a truth different from the truth preached by the apostles.
那这里提到它有两个特色。
And it mentions the two special characteristics.
第一个叫做不敬虔的私欲。
First is that,
八节最后一句。
That they have their own ungodly lusts.
那第二个叫做属乎血气而结党。
Secondly, they are also characterized with sensual and cause divisions.
这个血气在哥林多前书里面有讲属血气的不能够领会神的事情。
In 1 Corinthians, it tells us that people who are sensual-minded, they cannot understand the will of God.
原来意思叫 natural man, 自然人。
And another interpretation is a natural man.
就是生下来，这个叫做属血气的。
Anybody who is born of the flesh, they are of the flesh.
凡有血气的都像草，像花，就是父母生我们，就是属血气的。
Whoever is of the flesh, when we are born in the flesh, and we are like a flower and grass.
那这样的人呢，他没有办法去领会神的事情。
Such type of person cannot fully understand God's will.
因为下面说他没有圣灵的人。
Because it says that they do not have the Spirit of God.
那人没有办法去领会神的事情，有时候热心变成什么？这里叫做结党，英文叫 division， 变成分撇了。
When a person fails to have the spirit and understanding of God's truth, then they will tend to cause divisions.
但是如果我们被圣灵充满，
but if we are filled by the Holy Spirit,
这个神的灵带领我们，
the Holy Spirit is leading us.
大家归向神，
and everyone is turned toward God.
那这样我们就会在灵里面合一。
Then we are able to become united in the spirit.
那前面一个
in the previous point,
说不敬虔的私欲。
Talk about the ungodly lusts.
这个也要用真理跟圣灵来改变。
This also requires the truth and the Holy Spirit in order to transform us.
如果我们不认识真理，我们不晓得什么叫私欲。
If we don't understand the truth, then there's no way we can tell what is ungodly lust.
认识真理才说，这个叫做私欲。
Once we understand the truth, then we realize what is ungodly lust.
在加拉太书里面写得很清楚。
And it's very well defined in Galatians.
那加上圣灵的祷告。
And added upon the often prayer in the spirit.
那这个神性一直进来，我们这个私欲越来越少。
And God's divine nature will come pouring into us, and less we'll have less the ungodly lusts.
罪性越来越少。
And that means our sinful nature is suppressed to the minimum.
那你就发现我们这个教会就越来越合一啊。
And we will discover that the church has become more and more harmonious and more united.
所以教会如果要合一啊，离不开三件事情。
For a church to be united as one, there are three very essential ingredients.
第一个要在真道上来造就大家。
One is to build everyone up in the truth.
我们有共同的信仰。
We have our common faith.
第二个。
Second.
要有圣灵的运行跟感动。
We need to have the movement and the touching of the Holy Spirit.
那第三个就是第三点。
And third, which is what we just discussed.
保守自己藏在神的爱里面。
We need to keep ourselves often in the love of God.
就是有爱的一种团契。
We need to have this fellowship of love.
这个爱是不喜欢不义，只喜欢真理的。
Love does not delight in unrighteousness, but rather in truth.
是很纯的。
Love is very pure.
那一个教会如果有这三样，
if a church has these three ingredients,
这个教会非常平稳。
Then this church would be very stable.
不是少数人能够改变什么。
And it would not be rocked by a few individuals.
因为大家都明白道理。
Because everyone understands the truth.
对就对错分得很清。
And they can differentiate right from wrong very clearly.
大家都有圣灵在感动。
Everyone is moved by the Holy Spirit.
所以不是出于圣灵的，我们心里会知道。
Whatever is not out of the Holy Spirit, we can sense it immediately.
大家都有神的爱。
And everyone has the love of God.
不是出于神的爱，我们会感觉得到。
Whatever is not out of the love of God, we can sense it.
那这样，这个教会就很平稳。
And through this, the whole church will be very stable.
所以从长远的教会的发展跟平稳。
So looking at church from a long and stable perspective,
这个是需要做的三个方向。
These are three very essential directions we need to strive for.
有系统的用真理造就大家。
To systematically build everyone up in the truth.
推动祷告，大家被圣灵充满。
And to encourage praying in the Holy Spirit to fill everyone up.
用基督的爱来彼此团契。
And to unite everyone up in the love of Christ.
这个教会是合一的。
Then this church will be one and united.
是有神同在的。
Has the abidance of God.
是充满着恩典。
It is filled with grace of God.
那这样啊，神怜悯我们，就可以保守我们一直到永生。
And through this and God's mercy and protection, then we can continue on to eternal life.
唱诗。
Sing hymn.